Just last week, Health Canada approved PaxLOVID, Pfizer's oral pill that helps treat mild to moderate cases of COVID-19. And on January 31st, the first shipment of it will be available for Albertans. But Jason Copping and Dr. Deena Hinshaw are still urging you to get vaccinated, as not everyone will be able to access this new treatment.
The criteria include immunocompromised individuals age 18 and over, regardless of their vaccination status, who have received transplants, who are cancer patients and have received chemotherapy or another immunosuppressive treatment in the past 2 years, or who have an inflammatory condition that they are being treated for.
Hinshaw adds PaxLOVID will also be a possible option for Albertans 65 and older who are unvaccinated or 18 and older with a pre-existing health condition. While the pill has been approved, Hinshaw and Copping say there are risks of reducing antiviral resistance to COVID-19 if it's used improperly.
A patient must have a PCR-confirmed COVID-19 infection. Due to such a limited initial supply, the drug will only be available at select number of pharmacies in the province by prescription and after an assessment by AHS HealthLink.
Copping stresses don't contact your local pharmacy or clinician to receive PaxLOVID, reiterating the use of the drug is promising but not intended for all.
A very serious situation is unfolding at the border. A week ago, I issued a statement saying that Canadians have a democratic right to engage in lawful protests. I urge those involved in the truck convoy protest to do so as safely as possible and not to create road hazards, which could lead to accidents or unsafe conditions for other drivers. If participants in this convoy cross the line and break the law, I expect the police to take appropriate action. Let me say to those vast majority of lawful protesters, I hear you. I understand the concerns and frustrations that you have. And for those opposed to the quarantine requirement for cross-border truckers, not only do I hear you, but I agree with you, and I went to Washington, D.C. to find allies to seek an exemption for the application of the quarantine requirement for cross-border truckers from both the Canadian and United States governments. Unfortunate to see a small number break the law, create a public safety hazard, and enormous inconvenience for law-abiding Canadians, including thousands of other truckers, by blocking the border at Coutts.
Our members here on the ground made inroads to go and start to clear vehicles from the northbound lanes of the blockade. We brought in our special tactical operations unit, and they were going vehicle to vehicle, talking to anybody in the vehicle, giving them the opportunity to leave before they were arrested. While that was taking place, we had a bunch of vehicles and farm machinery that were to the north at a roadblock that was set up on Highway 4 to the north. Those vehicles breached the roadblock, and they did that by driving at quite high speeds through the ditches and fields and things like that to get around the marked police units that were there. This created a dangerous situation on Highway 4. There was actually a head-on collision that occurred during that time. While all this was unfolding, our STO operators were still at the scene of the blockade itself. Given the mounting danger on Highway 4, there was actually an assault that took place on that highway as a result of that head-on collision. One of the people, I don't know if that was a protester, two protesters, I'm not exactly sure of that, but one protester did get into an altercation with a vehicle that they had a head-on collision with, and an assault occurred. Not a significant one, no significant injuries. Tension remains to restore movement of goods and vehicles on the road, but not at the risk of public safety. That's why we had to reposition and reconsider for the time being earlier today.